We have prepared a comprehensive and detailed tutorial, Microsoft Paint 3D step-by-step detailed introduction and interface tutorial for beginners and those who want to learn. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. Paint 3D is a raster graphics and 3D modeling application, a revamped version of Microsoft Paint. Whether you are an artist or just want to doodle, Microsoft Paint 3D is a great way to unleash your creativity and bring your ideas to life. Paint 3D, the easy-to-use drawing and design application, is designed for Microsoft Windows 10 and later. While it is readily available in Windows 10 versions, it can be downloaded and installed for free in a very practical way from the Microsoft Store for use in later versions such as Windows 11. If it is installed on your device, you can access the program by searching for it in the Start menu. Or we open the program by clicking on the Microsoft Paint 3D symbol from MS Paint, that is, Edit with Paint 3D. Or we can also access it by typing the program name from the Start menu, as we just mentioned. As soon as we open the program, we are greeted with a welcome message. In the welcome section, there are options to start a new project or to start an existing project, and we also have the possibility to import 2D or 3D work from outside. If we want, we can uncheck so that the welcome screen does not appear. There are two introductions on the welcome screen. One is a library of 3D assets and a short introductory clip about some new tools. Of course, we will go through them quickly, but we strongly recommend you to watch them. When you start a new project, you start with a clean canvas. Canvas is the name of the surface on which we draw and design, similar to real life. In the middle of the light gray workspace, you can see the canvas. With a white background color and the simplest terms, canvas is the area where we draw and design. On the right is the tool properties panel, which changes according to the selected shape tools. At the top of the editor, you can see a section with toolbars and basic commands. When I select the brush tools, the tool properties panel on the right side shows the settings for the brush. When I select shape tools or other tools and options, the tool properties panel on the right side changes according to the relevant tool. The top panel consists of two sections, and the bottom layer has commands like selection and cropping, as well as zooming in and out of the workspace and other quick commands. When we hover the mouse cursor over each tool or command, a short information box of the tool or command will appear after some time. More command options include undo, copy, and paste, which is available in many programs, as well as some programs' specific preferences and features. For example, the interaction control preference provides us with a visual shortcut for workspace management interactions with tools such as mouse, keyboard, touch, or digital drawing pen. We will cover each of these tools and preferences in more detail in the next section, but for now we will try to describe some of their locations and functions on the interface. One example is holding down the Alt key with the drawing pencil to pan, that is, to move freely around the workspace or canvas. Another example is that if we use a mouse as a shortcut, we can zoom in and out of the workspace or canvas with the mouse wheel. We can scroll, that is, move freely, by holding down the wheel button of the mouse tool or by holding down the left mouse button and the Alt key All this is also illustrated individually with finger gestures for touchscreens. There are also preferences such as switching to canvas settings and taking a quick screenshot. And new commands are also available at the top. And if we are using a keyboard, we can also use the Control plus Z key combination. We can collapse and expand the area of the top toolbar with the arrow key here so that the names of the tools are only visible when you hover over them. When we come to the menu section, on the far left of the top section, you're greeted with a section with general settings such as save, import, export, and general settings that you can find in every program. Within the settings, there are two different settings to show the sidebar. In other words, the panel window where the properties of the tools are shown in a wider or narrower area. Narrowing the sidebar area has the advantage of freeing up extra space for the workspace, and we'll show you both of these options step by step. We have switched to the compact view preference, and let's go back to the workspace from the return option above, and observe the change in preference. As you can see, the sidebar, the tool preferences panel, has narrowed and the workspace has expanded. When we get to the relevant section, the details of the tool properties temporarily expand, and when the mouse cursor moves away, it automatically switches back to the compact view, so that we can choose to be more compact and maximize the workspace. However, we uncheck and reinstate the compact view preference, which will mean a little more workspace shrinkage. But all tool options will appear in their full form. You can use it with any preference you wish. This is all about working comfort and preference. There are preferences such as render and display quality performance settings, which we will discuss in more detail below. And enabling or disabling the welcome screen at startup. Going back to the workspace, we mentioned earlier that when we select a tool, there are changes in the sidebar. In other words, the tool properties panel. For some tools, there may be subsections, subheadings, and preferences within the panel. I draw V1 on the screen and open the menu section and expand it again. In the menu section, there may be previous projects and works that we may want to open, or there may be an image file or work in a different directory on our computer, and we can access these works and image files from the menu section. For example, below we can see the project names and saving dates of previous studies. If we want to start and work on a new project, instead of an existing or old one, we can choose to start a project by clicking on the section labeled New. When we want to start a new project, if there is a project we are working on and we have made changes to it, but we have not made the last saving, it gives a warning message. The warning message offers three different ways to choose whether to save the current project or close it without saving, or to cancel the new project start. With cancel, you can cancel starting a new project. Starting a new project means exiting an existing project, which means you can only open one project at a time. You can start a new project while you have an existing one. But if you quit without saving, this means that the project or the changes made will be completely lost and never accessible again. We created a new untitled project with the Start a New Project command. With the Open File command from the menu, We import the cropped wallpaper project called Test V3 from the desktop into the Paint 3D editor. In the lower parts of the menu section, there is the option to share the work we have done or the image files we have opened with screenshots or directly via email or different ways. And we will talk about the details in the future. With the print command in the menu section, it is possible to print the work we have done or the image files we have opened from the printer. Of course, we can print 3D works from a 3D printer. After you have set the settings for the printer, you can print. We will get into the details of all this later. But for now, our aim is to try to introduce the interface in general. What's new? The option brings up the login screen, including the new features introduced in the welcome menu at the first startup. If no changes have been made to the existing file or work, we can start a new project with a single command if there is nothing to record. As we mentioned before, the new command from the menu creates a clean new project without a title. We have already shown the different ways to navigate. Zoom in and out in the workspace, and we can also navigate left and right or up and down with the scroll bars. We can prepare a detailed content on navigation, but what we have shown in the interface lesson will be enough. And the ability to minimize the editor window, close the screen completely and resize the editor, which is available in almost every program, is also available in the Paint 3D editor. To import external image files, we can add them to the current work by drag and drop. For some examples, we add a few image files that we have previously prepared on the desktop to our open project in the Paint 3D editor by drag and drop. Since the purpose is to show, we also cancel the external files we have included with the undo command. This series of tutorials on our channel we'll teach you step by step how to use the Paint 3D editor, each one covering a different topic. We will start with basic tasks and gradually move towards more complex features. Each chapter will build on the knowledge from the previous chapters so that you can learn effectively and efficiently. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.